cell signal? What is receptor and what is secondary messenger? Any difference for all the three? Cell signaling, receptor and secondary messengers. Cell signaling, it is an homeostasis mechanism. Can you give an example for that? Example for homeostasis mechanism. But it is one of the regular physiological processes occurring in our body. Homeostasis. Give one example for that. Maintenance of temperature then?
Immune response.
B lymphocytes, T lymphocytes, antigen antibody reactions. The production of antibodies in response to the antigen, various type of antigen. So that is considered as homeostasis mechanism. That is balanced by cell signaling and receptors. And sometimes secondary messenger is also involved. So initially, in the first two slides, I will explain about what are the content of cell signaling, receptor and secondary messenger. Just what are the content. So the need for signaling in multicellular organism, extracellular signaling molecules bind to the receptors. So these are the six properties. Most are bind to receptors on the cell surface. And then some passes through the membrane. And there are different types of extracellular signal molecules. And then most signal molecules are secreted by exocytosis. What is exocytosis? Release of? Outside the cell, exocytosis. From inside the cell to outside the cell. So endocytosis means from outside to inside. Pinocytosis? The transfer of liquid molecule from outside the cell to inside. Or inside to outside. So the transfer of solid particle from outside the cell to inside. Endocytosis. Okay? So others diffuse through the membrane and then others remain bound to the surface. These are the few properties related to the signaling molecules bind to the receptors. And the receptors is usually they are on the cell surface. Actually, the receptor is present mainly on cell surface, and then sometimes they are inside the cell. So both the possibilities are there. The receptors are present either in the cell surface or inside the cell. And there are four major types of signalings. The last part, secondary messengers. So that is paracrine signalings, sympathetic signalings, endocrine signalings, and autocrine. So these are in brief about this chapters, and then the different cells may respond differently to the same signal. Or one particular signal, the cells behave in a different pattern. So the response depends on the cell surface, the receptor. Response depends on the environment, intracellular machinery. For example, acetylcholine, a neurotransmitter. So it behaves like in the response to the surface receptor. And it behaves like in response to the environment. And then it behaves like then intracellular machinery. Intracellular machinery. So it is equivalent to this is a triangle in plant cell. This is a triangle. What is this is triangle? Any type of disease develops in a host, it depends upon three factors. One is environmental factor, another is host, another one is pathogen. The environmental factor, host, pathogen, all the three must be favorable for a particular disease. So the host is susceptible, and then pathogen is virulent. The pathogen is virulent, environmental condition is favorable. At this time only the disease is developed. In opposite characters, that is the